It's weird. Like, I don't wake up in the morning like I'm a pro bike rider. You know what I mean? I'm just a normal person and just enjoys riding his bike. And just like there's people that enjoy, you know, playing the piano or making art or whatever it is. Dirt jumping essentially is like my main deal. The feeling of dirt jumping, it's like the point of weightlessness when you're in the air. You get into a rhythm, you're just flowing. I don't know, it's just a really cool feeling. I would ride my bike pretending I was riding a dirt bike. I think 18 is when I did my first pro contest. And I was like, wow, I think I could do this. I want to ride dirt until I'm 60. My parents, they kind of set a good belief system in my life. But there comes a point in everyone's life where they have to make it their own. I mean, there were times in my life where I kind of rebelled against my faith. With the rebellion, I started to see that, you know, the Bible is true when it says the wages of sin is death. Things in this life that we constantly try to fill our lives with that are just possessions in this world. In everyone's heart, there's only one piece of the puzzle that God can fill, and everyone tries to fill it with a bunch of different things. But realistically, he's the only one who can do it. So if he's not the one who's filling that hole in your life, then you will never be fully satisfied. I would say it really became real for me probably around 21-ish. I realized that, you know, it was a relationship and started talking with God throughout the day and just making him a part of everything in my life. Because if your relationship with God is on point, it's kind of like if your relationship with your parents is on point, you follow the rules that they have for you and you just do it because you respect them. And it's almost the same thing with God, where if your relationship with God is good, then there'll be a respect there to where you won't want to do the things that he says not to do because you love and respect him. I don't know if it's something that I made up in my own mind, that if I was a good person and I did the things that I was supposed to do, that, you know, good things would happen to me. Like, if you hear the saying, you know, good things happen to good people, and as much as I want that to be true, it unfortunately is not. So there's going to be trials in our lives, but there's also, if you persevere through those trials, God always says that he'll take care of us. And I don't mean that in the sense of he's going to make you rich or whatever it is that you're wanting. He's going to give you that new car. You can look at the disciples' lives and even Jesus' life. You can see that they went through a lot. I mean, 11 out of the 12 were all executed. God has a plan for each and every person. The things that I've gone through in my life, God has allowed them to happen to me, and he's taught me the things that he's taught me so I can help people that are in the same situation that I'm in. Having God behind you and having your back is way better than having a new car or whatever, fill in the blank, that's a worldly possession. There's gonna be trials, but God will always take care of you and he'll always see you through it. Religion can't save you. And that's what's so important about Jesus dying on the cross, is there's a freedom there with Jesus.